Happy Valentine's Day and our love here. Our love connection for food.
Yes.
Mr. Dave Eckert's back, our food journalist. Good to have you.
Hey, good to be here. Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
And to you.
And to you, sir. We're going to do a couple of different things.
Yes.
You want to do the champagne sparkling?
No, let's do this last.
Okay.
Let's do it last.
So I recently penned two articles, one for Kansas City Chowtown and the Kansas City Star, and one for Kansas City Homes and Style magazine,
yeah,
on the most romantic restaurants in Kansas City. 15 of them in all.
Okay.
So you can find those in those two magazines. And these are examples of some Valentine's Day and Valentine's weekend offerings from restaurants around town.
Okay.
So right here, we have from Chaz on the Plaza, which
ooh,
is considered by many the most romantic restaurant
that's
in town.
That's a good one.
Chef Sean Hartwig, love is in the air, four courses tonight and through the weekend, which is great because you can't get in tonight. They're sold out.
Oh, there you go.
$50.
Celebrate late.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Celebrate the other 364 nights, right?
Oh, yeah, because some of us have to wake up at 2 a.m.
Exactly.
So
roasted red pepper bisque, salmon with rosemary mashed potatoes and a white chocolate berry cream
goodness.
Sauce.
That looks amazing.
Moving over to the brass onion. Which is 135th and Knoll in Prairie Fire.
Yeah.
The crab cakes, some of the best in the city.
Look at that.
Unbelievably
that looks
good.
I
and then we have, next to that,
the red velvet
bundt cake. Executive Chef Chris Rondo, four courses, $65 with wine, 25 more. And you can have all of the menu or some of the menu all weekend long. So that's really neat.
That's amazing crab cake.
Oh, those are really good.
All right, in the center.
What's this?
This is from Jack's Fish House and Oyster Bar.
One of my favorite places in
Kansas
City.
Love it.
I love sitting at the bar and watching them shuck the oysters.
It's a great place to hang out at the bar or in the restaurant. Mm-hmm. Now, they have a four-course menu with an amuse, $65, $25 for wine pairings. Chef Brian Sparks has created that. That's available tonight and through the weekend. And then there's this. This is what they're calling an aphrodisiac sampler platter.
Oh, my.
So you can have this all weekend long for $30. And what you get, three oysters, caviar, three truffles, and some sparkling wine.
Okay. Now, there's a proper way to open a sparkling wine if you're
You're getting ahead of yourself.
Okay. Well, we're running out of time, Dave.
Okay.
You gotta calm them down.
Aphrodisiacs, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
So I did some research. Oysters. Casanova ate 50 oysters for breakfast every day. High in zinc stimulates the libido. True. Caviar, source of amino acid. Vascular dilator, stimulates blood flow, if you know what I mean.
Kay.
Chocolate contains high levels of a chemical known as PEA, which stimulates the endorphins, leads to feelings of excitement.
A lot of stimulation going on.
A lot of stimulation, and finally, stimulation through sparkling wine, which doesn't do a darn thing, except alcohol lowers inhibitions, right?
That's true.
And I would know.
And sparkling wine delivers the alcohol into the bloodstream faster.
Really?
This is true.
That's
and here's how you open it up.
Okay.
You just very gently.
Like that.
Like that. It shouldn't
like
be a loud
whisper.
Pop. Kind of a whisper.
Well, let's taste that.
Let's taste it, shall we?
Now, I highly encourage you to follow Dave at Eats and Drinks with Dave on Instagram. Also online, does some great articles with homeandstylekc.com.
And KC Chowtown.
And KC Chowtown. He is all over the place. Dave is like the expert, the foodie of Kansas City.
I am.
Cheers.
And happy Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day.